Hello students, welcome back to the class. So the last class we have discussed about the miscellaneous functions of Supreme Court. In that we have discussed about what are the other and extra power of Supreme Court. In this class we are going for a new topic and a new chapter. We are going for the fourth chapter. In this chapter mainly we will discuss about the powers, okay, important powers of governor, chief ministers. What are the power and functions of state legislative assembly, legislative council, etc. So now today, in the sense, in this class we will study about the powers and the function of governor. What are the important powers and what are the important functions of governor, we will discuss in this point. Okay children, we will go forward. Power and the functions of governor. Now first, if you are saying governor, according to the constitution they should be the governor of the state. Okay, so governor is a constitutional head of the state. Okay, the head of the state, the constitutional head of the state is governor actually. Just like how the president is the constitutional head of the country, similarly the governor is also the constitutional head of the state. Okay, second thing, the according to article 155 article, governor will be appoint, all the appointment of governor will be made by president only, according to article 155. So if you are seeing the article 155, all the appointment of governor will be made by president of the country. President only will appoint the governors. Okay, all the appointment of governor will be under the control of president according to the article 155. Now president can appoint, and here the point is president can transfer the governor. So for transferring the governor, okay, that is also under the control of president only. So appointment will be under the control of president, and transferring of governor to other state, that is also under the control of president only. When we are discussing about the appointment, the maker of constitution have adopted the Canadian model. From Canada they have adopted a model for appointment of governor. So this appointment and the process of governor we have appointed, we have adopted from the model from the Canada. Okay, so in Canada first, in the constitution in the Canada, so they have prepared some process how to appoint the governor. So that process was adopted by the India. So we have taken the model of Canadian model. Okay, Canadian model we have taken to appoint the governor, appointment of governor. That is one point. Okay, next point, if you see according to article 153, constitution has given, okay, constitutional has given some power to the governor. So governor has more power. So governor has some sufficient power, okay, to control the legislative assembly and to control the state. So constitution has given some power. In this point mainly we will discuss about first appointment, okay, salaries and allowances. We will discuss about governor, we will discuss about the tenure, what are the terms, and we will discuss about the qualification and what are the executive power of governor. First we will discuss about what is the main executive power of governor in this chapter. Okay, so here we have discussed that according to article 153, the constitution has given some power to the governor. So one governor can be appointed for more than one state, but that on the direction of president only. On the direction of president sometime the governor will be appointed for not only one state, but also the governor will be appointed for more than one state. Two states are more than two states are three states. One governor can be appointed for more than two states only on the after the direction of president of India. So after the direction of president of India, the governor will appoint for more than two states after the directions which are made by the president of India. Okay, this is one point. Okay, so it means that governor can be appointed for more than one state. Now if you see, now when we are coming forward about the salary, the total income the governor will receive the income is nearly 3,50,000 rupees. Recently whatever the modification which was done according to the pays and allowances in 2018, all the pays and allowances has been modified at central as well as state level. So at state level if you see, the governor are going to pay at a income of 3,80,000 rupees will be paid to the governor. Next will go 3,50,000 rupees, sorry. Next, governor will be given a nilayam which is called as Raj Bhavan. Okay, Raj Bhavan, in which the governor will get all the types of facilities. Okay, in terms of living facilities, residence will be given. and that resident is called as Raj Bhavan. So governor, what he will do, he can able to reside in Raj Bhavan. So that facilities for residents will be given for the governor. We can able to reside in Raj Bhavan. That facilities are given to governor. Apart from that, the government will pay all these pays and allowances from the consolidated funds of India. These funds, every central government will maintain the consolidated funds of India. From that consolidated funds of India, the government will be given all the allowances. Most of the allowances which are paid to the ministers are mainly given from the consolidated funds of India only. Okay, whatever the governor will get allowances, which will be mainly given from the consolidated funds of India only. So here what we have discussed that first, according to the constitution, they should be the governor, and governor is the constitution head of the state. Okay, according to the article 155, we have seen governor will be appointed by president. Okay, second thing we have seen that the appointment of governor we have taken from the model of Canadian model. So we have, India have adopted a Canadian model for appointment of governor. And we have discussed that according to article 153, okay, there are some constitutional power which are given to the governor, and one governor can be appointed for more than two states on the direction issued by president. Only after the direction issued by the president, sometime what will happen, one governor will be appointed for more than two states also. This is also one point. So next we'll go forward. So at least when we are talking about allowances, every governor will be given 3,50,000 rupees income, and governor will be given a residence which is called as Raj Bhavan, and pays and allowances are mainly given from the consolidated funds of India. These consolidated funds of India, the central government will maintain, and through that, the consolidated funds of India, the governor will get pays and allowances. Next, when we are talking about the terms, tenure, the total terms of governor will be nearly 5 years. He can able to hold the office for the period of 5 years, and if he wanted to hold more than that, that always depends upon the pleasure of president. If the president feel satisfied, then the governor can able to hold the office for a long period of time. So president, the pleasure of president. So governor positions are mainly depends upon the pleasure of president, because here the president will appoint and the president has a power to remove. President has only the power to remove. So here one point is, if the president wanted, he can able to transfer governor from one state to another. If the president wanted, he can appoint one governor for more than one state also. So everything is mainly depends upon the pleasure and pleasure of president only. If the president feel, he can appoint the governor for more period. Now this is also one point. And one more point is transfer. President, when he feel that governor should be transferred, so that is also mainly depends upon the president. So everything is depends upon the pleasure of president. Okay, so that is one point. So here we have discussed the term. The total term will be 5 years, and here the whole governor can able to hold the office for a long period of time, but that is mainly depends upon the pleasure of president, and governor can be transferred to any other state. Okay, that is also one point. Next we'll see about qualification. When we are talking about the qualification, what is the qualification of governor? First one, the citizen of India. Every governor should be the citizen of India. You should belong to the same country. Either if you are a president, prime minister, or whatever the positions you are participating or you are holding or you wanted to contest, first qualification is this only, citizen of India, and you should be 35 years of age, children. Either if you are electing for the president or either if you are appointing for governor, age is similar, 35 years of age you should have, or more than 35 years of age, but not less than 35 years. And if you are appointing for the position of governor, you should not be a member of legislative assembly. Similarly, president also, if you are appointed for president, you should not be the member of any legislative assembly. This is one point. Even for governor and president, the qualifications are quite similar, but difference is only one thing, that president is mainly applying for the central government, and here the government position is applicable for state level. So here third important point is, governor should not be the legislative members. He should not be MP from any of the house. Okay, he should not be the member of parliament. And no governor should hold office for the profit. Okay, whenever the governor, suppose if he is contesting for the governor and he is holding some offices for the profit, then he is not eligible. To become the eligible for the governor, you should not hold any type of offices for profit. So this four qualification is very, very important to become the governor of the state. First one, what we have discussed, citizen of India. You should be the citizen of India. You should complete 35 years of age, And third thing, you should not be the member of any legislative assembly. And fourth thing, you should not hold any type of offices for business, or you should not hold any type of offices for profit also. Okay, this is one point. Now, children, we are going forward. What are the executive power of governor? So in this point, we will completely discuss about what are the main executive power of governor. First one, if you see, according to Article 154, governor has many executive power. Okay, governor has vested some executive power. We will discuss what are the executive power of governor. First executive power of governor is, governor has a power to appoint the chief minister. So governor will appoint the chief minister. So chief minister will be appointed by governor. Of course, chief ministers are mainly elected by elections. It depends upon the number of votes. If the chief minister can able to secure the number of seats in legislative assembly, they will elect. But who will appoint? Election is different, appointment is different. First, any party are securing the maximum seat, they will be elected. Okay, but appointment will be done by only governor. Governor will give the invitation to the chief minister. Okay, and the appointment will be fixed by the governor. So my point to say, governor has an executive power. First one, he will appoint the chief minister, and he will allocate, distribute the positions. Portfolios are nothing but positions to the ministers. He will be allocating by the governor only. So governor will allocate positions and powers to the chief ministers. What are the various ministers are there? What are the role? Okay, responsibilities and role. And portfolios. Portfolios are mainly allocated by the governor only. And sometime if the governor want, he can able to reshuffle. Reshuffle is nothing but interchanging the position. Because sometime to avoid the corruptions, what will happen? To avoid corruptions, sometime the governor, what he will do? He has a right to reshuffle the ministers, interchanging the positions. Okay, interchanging the previous positions with a new position. So that is called as reshuffling. And then we have discussed that he will elect the vice chancellor. If he wanted to elect the vice chancellor, government has a power to elect the vice chancellor. Apart from this, the governor can regulate and transfer the IAS officer, all Indian service officers. So government can regulate them, and if the transfer is possible, governor has a right to transfer the IAS officer from one place to another place. So even that is also under the control of governor. Okay, so governor can regulate and governor can transfer the all Indian officers from one place to another place. Now here if you see that governor act as the chief secretary and advocate general. So governor is the chief, governor will appoint the chief secretary and advocate general of the state. At state level he will appoint the chief secretary and advocate general, who will play the very important role. Okay. Apart from this, the governor role is to appoint the state human rights commission. State human rights commissions mean they will protect the, they will fight on the behalf of human rights. Children, these commissions will fight on the behalf of human rights. Suppose if any fundamental rights are violated, then first state human rights commissions will fight. In the behalf of the citizen, they will fight. Okay. So these commissions are very important. There are different type of commission. Women commissions will be there, labor commissions will be there, children's commissions will be there. So this is also one point, state human rights commissions. State human rights commissions are nothing but these commissions are mainly fighted on the behalf of humans. Apart from this, the government will appoint the state finance commission and state election commission. So to conduct the election at state level, state election commission is very, very important. So and that's why to state election commission will be appointed to regarding elections point, election duty and all. So here we have discussed mainly what we have discussed about appointment, we have discussed. We have discussed about the salaries, we have discussed about the terms, we have discussed about the qualification, and then we have discussed about the executive power of governor. So what we have discussed? We have discussed that governor is a constitutional head of the state, and according to Article 155, governor will be appointed by president. Okay, and the maker of the constitutions has adopted the Canadian model for adopting the appointing governor. They have appointed the Canadian model. Then we have discussed that according to Article 153, the Constitution has given the power to the governor. So that depends upon the president. One governor can become the two states. He can take the responsibility of two states under the directions of the president. And terms, if you see, the governor will get, according to the recent modification which was done, according to the terms and conditions, according to 2008, recently they have modified the salary. So governor will get 3,50,000 salaries, and resident he can live in Raj Bhavan, and most of the pay, salaries and allowances will be given according through consolidated funds of India to the governor. And we have discussed about the term. The term of governor is nearly 5 years, and he can hold the office by the pleasure of president. And if it is possible, sometime the governor will transfer the person from one place to another place. Qualification, when we are talking about it, first should be the citizen of India, should be completed 35 years of age. Governor should not be the member of legislative assembly, and he should not hold any type of office for profit. So governor should not hold any type of office for any profit. Next, come to the point, what are the executive power of governor? According to Article 154, there are many executive power. First one, the governor has the right to appoint the chief minister. Second thing, allocating and distributing the positions, okay, and responsibility. So that is also under the control of governor. Governor will allocate the portfolios, and if it is possible, he will interchange the position, which is called reshuffling, okay. And governor will appoint the vice chancellor, and governor will sometime the regulates, and sometime he will conduct, or sometime he will transfer the all Indian service, and he will appoint the chief secretary, and he will appoint the advocate general. He will appoint the state human rights commissions. State human rights commissions will fight on the behalf of human rights. Okay, national human rights commissions at national level. How the human rights commissions will fight? For every state level, there is a state human rights commission. The head of state human rights commissions will be appointed by governor. State finance commissions will be appointed by governor. They will take care of all the finance matter. Whatever the financial related issues will be there, state financial commissions will take care of it. And state election commission, whenever the elections have to conduct, elections responsibility in the state level is under the control of state election commission. Okay, so children, we have discussed about what are the executive power of governor. So we have discussed briefly about the powers and function of governor. In the next class, we will discuss about what are the other powers of governor, like legislature, judiciary, etc. So this is very simple, and topic is very, very simple. Okay, so we will meet you in the next class, children. Thank you very much.